हाय फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर प्रकाश साळुंके, वर्किंग एज एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ वाल्चन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी. टुडे कंटिन्यूइंग विथ आवर डिस्कशन ऑन कंपैरेटर्स, टुडे वी शैल बी डिस्कसिंग न्यूमैटिक कंपैरेटर्स. एट द एंड ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर सेशन, स्टूडेंट्स विल बी able to explain principle and working of pneumatic comparator and will describe merits and demerits of them. A comparator is a precise instrument used to compare the dimensions of given components with the standard and measuring the deviation. The comparator which uses gas or air under pressure for their operations are called as pneumatic comparators. Now, the technique of using air in metrology, that is for measuring purpose, was first developed by the Solex company in France. Pneumatic gauging became popular in recent years due to the higher magnification range of around 30,000 is to 1, coupled with other advantages that we shall be discussing later. Now, principles of pneumatic comparator. Pneumatic gauging or that pneumatic comparators are based on Bernoulli's theorem. Now, can you tell me what is Bernoulli's theorem related with the fluids? You have studied it, isn't it? Okay. Yes, who can tell? Yeah. Bernoulli's theorem states that for a fluid system, total head or total energy remains constant. And for the fluid system, normally there are three heads. One is pressure head, another is velocity head, or it is sometimes also called as flow rate head, and potential head. In pneumatic comparators, deviation is shown by a variation in either a pressure head or a velocity head, provided potential head remaining constant. So potential head is maintained constant, and if there is a variation in one head, so that will vary the another head by equal amount but in opposite directions. So figure 1 illustrates the principle of pneumatic comparator. So let us see this figure. Yes, so this is the figure. So this shows that this compressed air is coming through the filter. Here is a pressure regulator unit. Filter and pressure regulator units are common for any fluid system, especially pneumatic system. And say here there is a control orifice, and it is named as CO and area C. So this is a chamber. This is a chamber whose pressure can be measured with the help of this pneumatic gauge. So there is one more orifice. So this is known as measuring orifice, and through which measuring jet emerges and air is going to the atmosphere. So here is restricting surface, and distance between the restricting surface and this MO, that is measuring orifice, is designated by L. Now let us try to see the working. Air at constant pressure P is allowed to flow through a control orifice CO, as we have seen in the figure, into an intermediate chamber and then to a measuring orifice through which air will escape to the atmosphere. So when there is, of course, no restriction, so air will be escaping to the atmosphere. Initially, there is no restriction to the measuring jet, and area of the CO, that is control orifice, and measuring orifice MO are such adjusted that incoming air flow is equal to outgoing one. Hence, there will not be any change in the pressure inside the intermediate chamber, so that is PI, and it will be equal to atmospheric. However, if the free flow to the atmosphere through the measuring orifice is restricted, then there will be rise in the pressure inside the chamber. Now, according to Bernoulli's theorem, say the pressure rise will be equal to decrease in velocity head. So there will be decrease in velocity head because there is a restriction, and so that will result in increase in pressure. So pressure rise and increase in pressure rise will be proportional to the decrease in the velocity head. For a small portion in the vicinity of measuring orifice, the outgoing air jet can be assumed to be cylindrical as shown in the figure. So if we refer the figure, so you can see, so here, so this is highlighted. So this is the measuring orifice. So this is the restricting surface. So this air jet which is emerging from measuring orifice and going to the atmosphere. So in this small, this vicinity, so it is almost cylindrical. So it is assumed to be cylindrical. And say with the diameter D, which is equal to the diameter of the measuring orifice. Flow rate will be equal to volume of cylindrical jet, so that is pi by 4 into d square into L, while d being, when d is constant, because diameter of the measuring orifice, that will be constant, the flow rate will be proportionate to L, so that is the distance of the restrictor from the orifice that we have seen in the figure. While using the comparator, initially a standard will be set to restrict the flow through the measuring orifice, and a zero reading of pressure may be set for this particular position, A standard component will be there. Now, then the standard will be replaced by different components for restricting the flow. If there is any variation in the dimension of the component from the standard, then L will change, If the component is of larger diameter, L will decrease. If it is of smaller dimension, L will increase. And because of will, so there will be reflection in change of flow rate and consequently change in pressure. So there are two methods to measure the deviation with pneumatic comparator. One is by measuring the air pressure. Another is by measuring the velocity or flow rate of the air. Principle remaining the same. Now, working of pneumatic comparator, which is also commercially known as Solex gauge or Solex pneumatic gauge. The instrument was first developed and produced by Solex Air Gauge Limited, France. So we can refer figure 2. The different components of this Solex gauge are, one is air compressor, then air filter and regulator unit, water tank and dip tube, manometer, control orifice, measuring head with measuring orifice. So let us see the figure. Yes. So this block, so that represents the compressor. So this is the filter and regulator unit. This is the control orifice. So this is the water tank and this is the deep tube. So this is the manometer arrangement, and say this is the measuring head or measuring gauge. So this is the component, so that is being measured. So this is the, so I mean this measuring component and the operation is highlighted. So let us first try to understand the, so I mean working. If the supply pressure is higher than the desired, some air will bubble out from the deep tube, so which is shown in this figure. So these bubbles, so the pressure, desired pressure will be maintained by the water level in this particular tank. If the supply pressure is excess of that, say then that pressure, I mean air will be bubbling out. Okay, so air at desired pressure will pass through this control orifice. So one is, it says this is the manometer, so manometer end is attached here and one end is here, so it will measure the difference here and here, the manometer. So this air will be going to the measuring head, so this is the measuring head, say that is for checking the bore. It is also called as air plug. So air through this bore will be passing through the atmosphere, and so this component, say, will act as a restrictor. Now what happens? The measuring head will be aligned with the standard component initially, which will indicate the pressure rise due to restriction of the flow. So this is the reference level. Now the different components are checked for deviation from this standard reference level. While measuring the bore, roundness can also be checked by rotating the measuring head, so that is our air plug, and taper is checked by moving the air plug through the length. Now, advantages and limitations of pneumatic comparators. Now, advantages are very high magnification, and because of this, say that comparator is very sensitive to even a minor deviation, so that can be checked. So the range will be, magnification range will be 30,000 to 1. Almost no moving parts in the comparator, hence very high accuracy, because naturally there will not be any friction, there will not be wear and tear. So over the period also there will not be loss of accuracy. It references from textbook of metrology by Mahajan, Dhanpat Rai and Company Private Limited. I thank to them and I thank you.